fucked up, right? I know. I know what y'all niggas asking yourself. Is he gonna ever fall off? No. Nothing different.
I know my mic is always muted.
I've been waiting for my moment to strike back. Well, we'll see, right?
Oh man. Yeah, they didn't say anything in that Discord about you, but they do know who you are because I've seen them talk about you before.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, it's pretty active, so he probably has
something like that. Anything you want to say about that? Just something to get their attention, because if they are so you're like in college now or
yeah, I mean,
you might as well just give yourself a quick introduction. I heard you're a cosmetic surgeon. Yes. Something like that.
Yeah, I'm trying to go into aesthetic plastic surgeries. I've interned a little bit at just kind of like, I guess would say like non-invasive surgery clinics where they do laser treatments and stuff like that. So I'm trying to get more into like what these guys would consider like bone smashing, like the actual like mandibular advancements and stuff like that. But right now I just do like mostly cosmetic surgery with like skin.
Okay, so you're like in college now or
yeah, I'm in med school right now. So I just finished my undergrad like last year, and I'm going into my second year of med school. So yeah.
Okay. Wow. So yeah, you should be more educated than the majority of the community then. So all good.
Yeah.
So do you watch like Black Belt content or?
Yeah, I've gotten into it. And how I got to know Stefan is I told him like how BS these face ratings are, because I've seen like some of these guys rate faces and they're just all over the place and completely like, I think you have a lot of videos on it because I remember watching your content a while ago and like just how you would call these guys frauds. And I would mostly agree, because like just the fact that these guys would rate like these, like some of these guys like really high scores and really low scores, it just kind of baffled me like how they come up with these numbers.
Wow. I mean, you probably say the same about me, because people say I'm kind of on the extreme low side. So I don't know.
Yeah, I don't understand.
You know, so call me out if you have to, right, bro.
No, I won't. I don't really understand your scale though, because I like, do you do it like, because I noticed like you rate like, is your average like a 3 out of 10?
Yeah, basically it's just down to like women's standards being higher now. So for them, like an average guy is kind of like perceived as unattractive. Like you don't see average as average, you know. So that's why I say they probably give an average guy, if they have to rate him, they'd say he's like a 3. You know, they wouldn't give a 5. Yeah. You know? So you see, I see girls like giving some like pretty attractive guys 5. You know, so
that's I understand that.
Kind of like 2 points lower than the standard.
Yeah, I can see that.
And so what's your kind of?
Oh shit!
Oh, give him a second.
Okay. So what's your like ideologies with like the dating market? Do you think it's all about looks, or do you think like game?
I am pretty black pilled, so I think it's like, I think looks is like 95, like looks and height are 95%, and then everything else is like the other 5. So I do understand that like the current dating market is mostly looks based.
You know the Ultimate Loophole Project? No.
No, I do not know who that is.
You ever heard of like Marcus Wolf? No. Or...
I've heard of them. I've never really watched them. Like the only people I really like keep up with are like you guys, and I do watch Tales a little bit.
Okay. Well, the Ultimate Blue Pill Project, they're dating coaches, you know, and Alex from Playing Fire as well. So they think that looks is 10 to 20%, you know, and Alex from Playing Fire thinks 30%. You know? So.
Yeah, I have watched a few Playing With Fire videos. I know you guys are that one guy that you rag on, the Indian Pie Man. I do remember that. And I agree with you guys, because I remember watching those videos, and it seems like he does kind of like fraud per se. Like I think he goes on Seeking and he just like says he has a lot of money, which I would argue that's not really like physical attraction. That's just a woman wants to use his assets.
Yeah, well, you know, Alex was caught in a contradiction, which his own editor confirmed himself by saying that when we were calling Indian Pie Man out for it, he was saying like, oh, but he has game, because when he meets up with those girls, obviously he needs game to make it work, you know, so how can you deny that? But then Myron from Fresh and Fit, when people were asking about him getting girls, he's like, oh yeah, but he uses like Seeking, so that's not really game, because he's just using like, you know, money and his so-called clout, you know? So it's like, so how can you say Pie Man has game, but then Myron doesn't? You see what I mean? It's just biased, you know?
Bit of a double standard.
Yeah, exactly. And we caught him on multiple things like that, but his fans continue just to, well, apparently we're the ones coping Stefan, right? So, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and we don't even get into. Well, we might as well start off with that. Like, what you, have you seen his girlfriend or not, okay, Kendrick?
Whose girlfriend?
Alex from Flame of Fire.
Natty. Yeah, I remember her. I heard like there was. Is it like an open relationship? Because I remember they were calling him out for that.
Oh well, it's open. Yeah, according to him, it's one way open. But you know, she was on camera.
Yeah, I don't know.
Two way, you know. But then once he got some hate saying like, "How can you let your girl do that? You're a dating coach." Then they decided to make it one way, and obviously she goes on her business trips, you know, and then. Obviously, we don't know what she gets up to in those times, but it's highly evident that there's something going on in the background. So, one way open on paper, you'll see.
Yeah, it's definitely interesting for a dating coach. I do think, like I was telling Stefan this, I think the last like actually like good dating coach, if you could say that, was Mystery, because he actually understood somewhat the importance of appearance. So he would like looks-max all of his clients before having them go out to pick people up. And obviously people would argue, oh yeah, well, there was like a 5'7" guy, so it's over for him. And while, yeah, that's true, at least he like made an effort to like in, like tell them the importance of appearance. But these modern guys that say, oh no, don't worry about appearance, it's just all game, like that's ridiculous in my opinion. Like I think looks, like I said, is 95%, maybe game. Like if you have really good game, it can make like a normie do better, but most of it just looks. Like obviously you're not going to see a true self slaying.
Well, that's their kind of out, because they say, oh no, we admit looks are important, but again, that's why they put like, you know, 10 to 20% or 30%, you know, like, oh yeah, it's something, but it's just not as much as what you think. So that's their way of saying like, oh, we're not one of these people who say looks don't matter. And I'm like, yeah, but you put it at such a low mark, so it basically is irrelevant according to you. So
yeah, I agree with that. I couldn't say it's any more than like 10%. If the guy's completely neurotypical and has literally everything else going for him, maybe 10%, but I like the 95.5 in my opinion.
Yeah, I understand. So his girlfriend, what would you, she's an attractive woman, right? Or what?
I've just seen pictures of her in thumbnails. She's not my type, putting it lightly.
What?
I'm a little hesitant. Yeah, like I don't want to like say, I don't want to be like really brutal about it, because I've seen like some of these guys like dox each other and stuff, so I don't want to get the wrath of Alex, but she's not my type. You can interpret it that how you will.
I'm just going to say, I think as the Black Brothers would say, you must be coping, because you know she literally looks like Megan Fox according to Alex.
Yeah, she's Stacey Light.
Stacey Light, freaking Stacey. Okay, what are you talking about? She should be in the movies. Oh,
yeah. I was wondering what you'd rate this woman. She spent like $30,000 on plastic surgery. Do you have that video, Stefan? Or let me try to see if I have.
What was that? What was her name again?
I'll try to find the link over here. Yeah, okay, here it is. So I was wondering, Gensar, what would you rate this girl after all of her surgeries? I put the link in the chat.
Okay, copy.
I assume she probably will look a bit inorganic, if you get what I mean.
But... yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. But we'll see. We'll get an objective look at it. Also, I should mention a lot of the procedures she received are temporary.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Yes.
He said her procedures were mostly temporary.
Yeah. So yeah, she got a lot of filler and like bread lifts, which both of those are like, I don't recommend them, because you literally have to get them, like filler, for example, like every few months you have to, or like a couple years, sometimes you have to get it. So it's pretty much an artificial look where you have to keep, like, it's not like a one and done thing, like a bone, like where they cut the bone and move it. Like they literally have to like keep getting it, or else she's going to look like what she did in the first picture there.
can she fix her carpal tilt? It's obviously like negative. Is there
something? Yes. Yeah, so that's the thread lifts I was talking about. Basically, they put like a needle and a thread, and they lift up your skin around your eyes. So that's how she changed her like eye area. But the problem with that, like I said, is it's like you can't just—it's not really permanent in that case.
She spent $30,000 to look like this. Let's see what she got and when she started. She even used a fake ID to get a procedure. That's very dangerous, and I'll tell you why.
I'm gonna need to see some identification. My name is Mia Dio, and I will be talking about everything I've basically gotten done to myself. Cosmetically.
The pendulum has definitely swung towards being more open about plastic surgery procedures. And I think mostly that's a good thing, but sometimes it might make people feel insecure if they haven't had any work done. So we have to be careful for the pendulum not to swing too far in that direction.
So before you judge me, I don't really care, because based off of this video, I am obviously my worst judge. You cannot outjudge me more than I judge myself in this life. I have gone from being botched to Barbie. And this is my story. So this is what I look like as a...
I think she's really underestimating how harshly we're going to judge her. Because
yeah,
I don't know if she's, I don't know if she's met black people before.
No, she hasn't. I'm hoping she doesn't see this, actually, because I don't know. If she already has body dysmorphia, this isn't going to do any good.
Yeah, I'm not going to go too hard, because because other people are on the panel, and I know George is going to report my streams for cyberbullying.
So oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm just going to be, like, I'm not going to give any opinion, but I was just interested, Ganstar, on your scale. What would you rate her before and after?
I'll give him a second.
Wait, so you want me to do the still image that we're staring at, and then the one to the right is before. So you're saying how much she improved, basically, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, she's probably... Well, you want, like, the normal scale, or do you want me to use my own thing?
The normal scale.
Okay, yeah. I'd say before, looking past the makeup, she was probably sub-5, like, you know, maybe, like, 4, 3.5, something like that, I'd imagine.
Yeah.
But now, I mean... Like, obviously, I know she's wearing a lot of makeup and all that, so it's kind of masquerading some facial flaws, but... I would say most guys would probably give her like 7 to 8, you know, on a normal scale. For me, I'd say it's probably like 5 at max, but that's done up and all that. So like that's on my scale, 5. So that'd be a 7 on the normal scale.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. What do you think? Well, I don't know if you want to give your input, Stefan, but...
Oh, no, I'll rate her. I'm just not going to I'm not going to throw too much foul language in there.
Yeah.
But Let me see. So before, because the thumbnail, I'm not going to judge off of that, because that's, I mean, the thumbnail was like a two or something, but her before, like right here, or like earlier, the one, where's that other picture? I guess it depends on what, like at what stage you're judging off, but like before, I would say like four at best. I mean, no, I got it now, three and a half. I got it. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. Because some of these I think are in the middle, like she may have gotten one or two procedures because there's some changes. But yeah, based on that picture that you judged at the beginning of the video, I would say like probably 3.5, because I think Natty looks better than her before picture. I can't find it.
Sadly, I probably agree, but only slightly, you know.
Yeah, like most of these before pictures are like a 3.5. Like this one right here on the right, I guess maybe a 4 there, maybe. But even that, she just looks weird. And that whole Alex thing where he gives every white person with blue eyes like a bonus, I don't do that. So if you're ugly, you're ugly. I don't care if you got blue eyes, green eyes. If you're ugly, you're ugly. So yeah, like 3.5.
Yeah, I agree.
But the new her, I would say, yeah, I didn't know he took up so much of this. Because I think another video I saw was her actual channel. Because Kendrick sent me this before over Discord. So I've rated her before. But I think... I know Noah would probably rate her like an 8. I would probably say, and I'm biased because I hate chicks with plastic surgery, because it's like I'm not going to have ugly kids with a fake, like a fake mom. So I am biased, but maybe like I'm trying to think. I'm trying to imagine like just walking into a party and seeing her there, not knowing she had anything done. Okay, if I see her in the middle, maybe a 6. Because, like, naturally good-looking high-tier Beckys, I think, are better than her. Like, they're just naturally, their harmony, is they don't have any, like, uncanniness, really. Like, even if they have a flaw, it's, like, more endearing of a flaw. Whereas, I'd say a 6. Because she's still attractive. Like, I wouldn't say, like, she's a 5. I wouldn't cope that hard. I mean, maybe 6.5, maybe.
That's what I would say. I'd say, like, 6.5.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe 6.5, like, just objectively. And then subjectively, I'd probably say she's a 6. On the normal scale, obviously. Oh shit! Sorry, I didn't know you dropped off.
Yeah, it's all right. Look, honestly, I think the lowest score on this with the makeup is probably gonna be a 6.5. But I think most people would give her at least a 7, and people like Noah, like you said, would go 8. You know, so yeah.
Yeah, I think it also is like biased because we all know she had surgery, so maybe our ratings would have been different if we didn't know that.
Well, I mean, yeah, I was trying not to factor it in, but like, yeah, I would say the universal scale would give her probably 7. Like, you know, I would say.
Yeah. And Noah would give her 8.5.
Yeah. But what about her cheekbones, though? They're kind of low set.
Yeah, I could kind of see that through the makeup. Also, something I thought was like a little uncanny. I know like she used lip fillers a lot, but I think the bottom lip, like it's a little bit too thick. Like it just, for something about that, just throws it off for me. Like even if I didn't like...
Yeah, go on.
Even if I didn't like know about plastic surgery, if I like, I don't know, something about her lips just like kind of indicates that she definitely had something done.
Should the bottom lip should be like, normally a good ratio would be like 2 times or... Is it to the top?
Yeah, I don't know. Well, it's just for me, it's because the bottom, see how it's like wider, like the top lip is like narrower, and then the bottom lip almost looks like swelling or something.
Yeah.
That's just what I noticed.
Well, no, honestly, I was trying to catch you up there. 2 normally be a little too excessive for the bottom. It's like, isn't it like 1.5 or something like that? That should be, the bottom should be a bit bigger than the top lip. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I've seen on some other pictures of her, the upper lip was a bit fuller, almost too full, because it's like almost 1-to-1, which would be, you know, too much, right? But so that obviously implies that she goes through phases of going through those fillers and all that, and taking less dosages as well. But
yeah.
But what we're looking at here, it looks less plump compared to some of the other images that were played before. But overall, I mean, 30,000. What do you think would be the most costly procedure she did, based on what you're seeing?
Out of everything she did, you could argue that since even though fillers are relatively cheap, it like depending on the amount of time she got them, because from where I'm from, each tube of fillers is about $1,500, and you have to get them every few months, so that adds up. But I think she got thread lifts. I think those were about 5 to 7,000 from where I'm from. But I like, that's what surprised me about the video, because she didn't really get any like what we would consider hard looks maxing, where like there was like any like severance of bone or anything like that. It was mostly just temporary things. So that kind of baffles me how she got it up to 30,000 with just stuff like that. I'll try to find the original video. Where she like details everything she did.
Oh yeah, it's in my Discord history.
I can just find it. I'll just look it up. All right, there we go.
do you think that she, I'm surprised, like, she didn't try to, like, lose the excess skin on her, like, septum? Can she, is that easy or not to get rid of that?
Oh, let me see. Sorry, I'm just trying to find the video.
Oh, that's all right.
It's an ad, I think. Oh, they're making me, okay. I thought I was going to watch that whole freaking ad. Okay. There we go.
Hello, everyone. Oh my god, Mia, your face looks so
there we go. Done? Sorry, what was your question about the septum?
Hello everyone, welcome back or welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mia Dio, and I will be talking about everything I've basically gotten.
Can you pause the phone? Yeah, I'll go.
Oh. Oh, give him a second.
So I was saying about the skin on her septum. I'm surprised that she didn't try to remove that. So she must think that she has a pretty good nose since she didn't.
Yeah. Yeah. I think she'd be a good candidate for a septoplasty, which, believe it or not, is actually not that expensive. It's about 3,000 to 6,000. Like, that's what they'll list it as. But in my experience, it's like 4,500 if you go to a decent surgeon with, like, all the anesthesiologist charges and whatnot.
And would you imagine it boosting her quite a bit? Like, do you think, like, the results are normally, like, quite, you know, decent? Or do some people look worse when they get the procedure done or not?
Yeah, I have seen people that have gotten, like, that procedure in nose jobs. That, like, obviously everyone always sees the TikToks where it's, like, a massive improvement, like, if they have a hook nose at first. But I've seen it a lot, like, where I'm from, where they'll get, like, a nose job, but it, like, reduces the size of the nose or makes it more flat, like, kind of pudgy. And it actually, in my opinion, it's, like, a massive downgrade to what they originally had. That's mostly for women, though.
Well, the thing I'm saying is that because she's so, like, obsessed with surgeries, the fact that she did not touch that part of her nose just makes me think that she must not have noticed. So us saying that, if she's watched it, she would be, like, so, like, self-concerned about it, going, oh, goodness, I didn't notice.
Yeah, yeah, that's kind of why I, like, probably hesitate to, like, recommend list out all the surgeries. But I would agree with you, like, with that. But, yeah, like, I just think, like, she did, I wish, like, if I were her, if I could redo it, I would spend it on, like, maybe more permanent surgeries, like maybe a canthoplasty for the eyes if she wanted to, like, permanently improve her eye area.
How much would that cost? Would you know?
I've seen them go for around 10,000, like, where I'm from. It's kind of, like, more expensive, but at the same time it would be permanent, so she wouldn't have to, like, keep getting those thread lifts and whatnot.
Yeah,
and that's why, like, part of the reasons I actually, like, streamed the first time with Stefan is I don't really like the way, like, some of these face raiders, like, they'll be like, oh, just get all these surgeries, bro, but they don't, like, factor in the complication rate, like the dangers of getting the surgery. Like they just assume, like, oh, you can just walk in, pay money, get a surgery, but it's not nearly that simple. Like, especially with implants, like, you have to worry about a lot of factors in the long term that they just, like, they're like listing out, like, it's like a catalog, and they don't realize that each of the surgeries they're listing has its own, like, degree of risk associated with it.
Yeah, that's understandable. Are you familiar with Greg or not?
Greg Lurick?
Yes,
I am very familiar with him.
Oh, crap. Let me add you back.
Are you, like, trying to not cause too much drama here? Or
yeah, like, I just don't want... I'm a little hesitant about that because I've seen how mad some of these guys get. What I will say about Greg, though, is, like, he does have some good features. I'll say that for sure.
Well, you like to hear that. Oh, good.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Stefan, do you want to play this, or do you want to move on?
Oh,
to
yeah. Well, I don't know if you guys want to talk. I mean, this was Kendrick's thing. I don't know
Well, yeah. I mean, do you have any other things you want us to see about her, or was this pretty much it, or what?
No, I was just wondering what you would rate her, just because a lot of people, like, don't really factor in, like, the, like, outcomes of plastic surgery in the black pill. But I was just curious because I know, like, you're a notoriously, like, unbiased rater, but in a good way. Like, you're not going to sugarcoat things. So I was just wondering what your opinion would be.
Yeah. So, I mean, what were you expecting me to rate her, like, lower than what I said, or what?
No, I think that's about on point.
Okay, I'll go. Dan, are you familiar with Ashley?
No, I'm not actually.
Oh, okay. It's all right. Forget it. Okay. So,
it's called being a six, Black V Silver. Jesus Christ. Oh, I know you're being sarcastic. I know. Well, I don't know, because some of you Greg simps, I don't know whether to take you guys serious or not. Like,
we'll leave it to, like, a
calling
mystery.
Someone a six, calling someone, oh, I'm sorry, again. What'd you say?
Go on, sorry.
No, I was going to say calling someone a six is an insult to a lot of these guys. So they can't accept just being a six. They have to be a Chad Light. But I'm assuming BBS is being sarcastic, though.
I was going to say that it'll be a mystery because Kendrick's not going to say how much positive features he's going to unveil. He's just going to say, yeah, here's some positive features.
His, like, the first feature I saw, because before I was black belt, I actually saw one of Greg's videos where he was mad about the Wheat Waffles face rating he got, which, like, to be honest, I do disagree with it because we rated him a 5 initially, which I think he was higher than that for sure. But I remember it because he had a good jaw in that video, I think.
Okay. What about for, like, the nose? Because I hear, like, you know, does that kind of perception that the nose isn't that important for a man, like saying, oh, if he has a bad nose, it doesn't
matter. That's cope. Yeah. Definitely. Because the nose is like one of, like, it's center of your face. It kind of accentuates everything. So if you have like, what's it called? Like, I think I should know this, like a hooked nose. That's like a lot of the procedures when I was interning at this one place, a lot of them, like it was majority nose jobs. And because a hooked nose, I think, is undesirable. Like you, I think men are starting to realize like they want, because even men, they wanted like just a smaller, like more narrow nose. So that's definitely like, even if you have, it like throws off harmony. And that's something like a lot of black pillars don't understand, is there's something called harmony. So if you have all these like Chad features, but they don't line up with each other, you just look like shit. And I think I told like on the last stream I did with Stefan, I brought up like examples of wraparound jaw implants where they had like a perfect 10 out of 10 jaw, but their nose was like fucked up. So it didn't really like mesh with it.
Yeah. Well, this, you have heard of Looks for L or not?
Sorry?
Have you heard of Looks for L or not?
I've heard of him. I've never like watched his videos. He's like at that like tall white guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've heard of him. I don't know a lot of these guys. Like, I don't watch a lot of these guys, but I'm like familiar with them.
I think well, we don't have to do it now, but I think at some point we should definitely pull up the video, Stefan, and get him to you don't have to rank them if you don't want, but maybe just, I don't know, because you said you don't want the drama. So the only person that would probably cause hassle for you would be Greg. So maybe you don't have to go too in depth with him, but the other guys wouldn't really do anything to you. So maybe you could like go over their features and say what you think, you know?
Yeah, the last time I rated like the face raters, because I know they probably don't really give a shit about their own rating. And there's a lot of other people that hate on them anyway. So I don't have like a problem rating like the face raters, because after all, that's all they do. So
Okay. So yeah, definitely at some point we should do that. And Stefan, I do want, because I haven't watched those Playing with Fire videos, because I was waiting to hear your reaction. So I also want to do that as well at some point as well. So what would you like to go over first, or what? Or do you have anything else that you want to touch on, or what?
Do you want to show him the wheat waffles video first, and Brian and Chained and Chadpill?
Okay. I mean, I'm just saying we can at some point, but if you want to touch on something, we can do that as well. I don't mind. You know, well, whatever you prefer, like, you know.
Oh yeah. It doesn't matter to me. Let me see. I wanted her video to play. Just wait. What?
Yeah. No, she did get a nose job. Okay. So it was like, she did get the nose job. I didn't notice. Okay. It was just like kind of wider, so she just made it like more compact, but she didn't use the septum surgery though. She just kept that, so she must have thought that it wasn't that bad, I guess, but damn.
Oh, that's actually a good shot of the threading right there. Like, it shows kind of how they do it. They mostly just pull your skin up.
Damn. I say to guys, if they want to improve their canthal tilt without surgery, I do recommend like what she's doing there with the eyelashes. I tell them to like grow them and point them upwards to create the image of the positive canthal tilt. What do you think of that?
That's interesting, because I was actually just talking about that with someone yesterday. But yeah, that's definitely like, even I have like a neutral or slightly negative canthal tilt, and I actually do that where I like, people will say it's gay, but I just curl my eyelashes, because it kind of like, I have like the, I forgot what the condition's called, but it's like double layered eyelashes, so they're a little bit thicker, and if I curl them up, it like gives the illusion of like what these guys would say, like almond eyes, where it's, or like hunter eyes, where it's like slightly positive. So that is a good strategy, definitely, without surgery, to do that.
Yeah, because I did my looks maxing video maybe like 5 months ago, and I haven't heard anyone else say that. So when I said it, some people were like mocking me, saying like, oh, who's telling guys to grow their eyelashes? What's that going to do? You know, but I was like, it actually can if you grow them to a decent length, you know?
That's the thing, like the people will complain and be like, oh, like, he really can't win, because if you say there's no way to improve it other than surgery, they'll call you a doomer. And then when you give them advice, then they'll be like, oh, well, that like, they'll make fun of it. So there's really no way to win.
Yeah, no, I just, because honestly, like when I said that, in the way I kind of got a bit of hate for it, I was kind of thinking, well, maybe I'm looking at it wrong, but it's good to hear someone with like more professionalism kind of give his take. So I appreciate that.
All right, no problem. No, I get, that's like, a lot of these guys are delusional. Like, especially like, I would say like, try all the soft looks maxing techniques first, like just stuff like that, as cliche as it sounds, like the just get a haircut. If you have like no hair, like you have a buzz cut, it looks horrible, and you like actually grow out your hair and do like the TikTok or whatever, where you cover your forehead, it definitely improves by like 1 to 2 points in some cases. So I would just try all that. Like, obviously I'm like, there are some people that are lean that are still like facially not very attractive. So in that case, maybe I would be like, consider like hard surgeries, like maybe jaw implants and advancements and stuff like that.
Well, yeah, like when I did my video, it was just about realistic looks maxing advice without like paying money, like, you know. So
yeah,
some stuff I went over. I said like, as well, for the eyelids, I said like, you know, eyelid pulling, stuff like that. Do you think that's kind of efficacious, or do you think that's not going to really work for most people?
I'd say that's kind of like, for me, that's in like kind of the same realm as mewing, where like it's hard to tell if it's like for sure effective or it's just like just confirmation bias. But I've seen it work. Like, some people claim they've done it, but it's like I said, kind of like mewing. There's no like definite way by science to prove that it works. But yeah, I mean, might as well try it. That's what my opinion of.
Whoa, it is. What? You can't be saying, you're saying mewing doesn't work. What?
Yeah, I mean, it's like good. Like, it's good for your breathing and stuff. But like, obviously, it's not going to perform a miracle. If you have like no chin, it's not going to grow you like several millimeters, like these guys.
No, that's what they all want you to believe. Brian on Shane Austin Wayne. They're like, Ewing, man, get that jawline out. That's all you need to do.
No. I actually used to have like, I will admit my chin is like slightly recessed, but I got a surgery a long time ago and where they actually did cut bone where it was covered by insurance. And this is just like kind of throws off all the surgery copers, but like literally like after everything was said and done, the cost of that surgery was like $2 million. And if insurance hadn't covered it, like obviously there's no way realistically, if that wasn't covered by insurance, that any of these guys can get some of that stuff done.
Wow. But,
okay. I just switched the Ethernet. So
you cut out. Well, while he's still, I'll say that. Oh, yeah, I can hear you now. Yeah. Any better?
Wait, Kendrick, you can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
I can't hear Kendrick. Oh, okay, now I can hear you. Okay.
Oh, is my mic like fluctuating in and out like last time, or does it seem to be good?
No, I can hear you.
I was switching to Ethernet.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Yeah, I'll disable the eyelid pulling. I noticed just randomly, like a couple of years ago, like one of my eyelids just like started like protruding more, and I was like, "Oh, what's going on?" So now it's like sometimes when I'm like really tired, they will kind of like sag out a bit, like you know. So sometimes when I do the pulling, it does masquerade it and like helps. So I don't think it's going to do anything long term, but I think if you get at the right angles, for some people, you can kind of place it back until it, you know, unless you're tired again, it's going to drop down. But
yeah, I agree. Yeah, I've noticed that definitely. There are things that vary it significantly, like obviously being under the effect of cannabis like increases your eyelid exposure, and also like not sleeping. So if you like stay up all night, I've definitely noticed like some nights like that where I get up, it's like I'm like, what the hell, because it's like a lot more eyelid exposure than usual. So it definitely like varies throughout the day, so pulling it might just kind of like put it back into place, so it might work.
Yeah, that's what I've noticed. Like some mornings I wake up and I literally have like no eyelid exposure. I like looking, I'm like, damn, it's like non-existent. But then again, like it's more on my left eye. When I'm just tired, it does seem to sag down, and I'm like, dang, well, stop, like, you know, I can't help it.
Yeah,
so like with the mewing on the video I did, I just said that it's not going to make all these miracle cures like people advocate, but like for someone who's never experienced jaw tension, which is, you know, most likely impossible if you eat food, you know what I mean? But I said if you're not familiar with the sensation, like I just said a basic couple exercises, like, you know, so I think, yeah, in those cases, but again, for most people, they have some tension in their jaw or their cheeks, like it's just a normal sensation from everyday life. So I just can't stand these frauds like telling people that like, oh, mewing will get you an insane jawline, and doing these before and after. And it was clearly just puberty, or they got some procedure done to make it look that much more effective, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like usually I remember there was even a case that's like they called out where a guy literally had like an x-ray, and in his own thumbnail you could see that he just got a chin implant, because like the bone, obviously, like in the first before picture, the bone was right up to the chin, and then after, he obviously, like the bone was several millimeters behind, so he literally just put in an implant.
Yeah, exactly. That's what some of these transformations that they're posting, I'm just like, there's no way that was done by just sticking your tongue at the top of your higher palate. I mean, get out of here.
Yeah. A lot of that is cope. Like, it is genetics, because obviously if you look at, if you have a weak jaw and you look at your history of your parents, they're probably, one side's probably going to have a weak jaw.
Yeah, exactly. And then Austin Wayne takes it to a new level where he's telling people he can make them grow with some magic beans he's selling. You know what I mean?
Does Wheat Waffles actually think he's a 6.5 out of 10?
Yeah. And he thinks 7 to 8 in that clip played there.
No. Okay, put it, I'm not a 7 to, like, out of 10. I think, like you said, like, 7 out of 10 is, like, an objective. I'm not talking about, like, what, like, the normie scale. But if you go outside, like, it's Chad Light is relatively rare to see, to be honest. Like, you're not going to, chances are if you go to, like, the supermarket, you're not going to see a 7 out of 10. Like, it's a lot rarer, like, than what people think. So, yeah, a lot of these guys, I think, like, I don't even like to rate myself, because, like, you're going to implement bias. It's just, like, it's kind of unavoidable when you rate yourself.
Yeah. Stefan, can we put it back to just Wheat Waffles? Can we just analyze him first and let Kendrick give an overall rating, and then we can move on to the next person?
I do think with Wheat Waffles, it's kind of an example of what I was saying, where he has good features, but there's like limitation of harmony. Like, obviously, well, a lot of people are going to like say, oh, well, he's a ginger, that's why. And while I partially agree with that, like, I just see, like, if he wasn't a ginger, I could look at him and I could say, well, he has good features, but something just looks kind of uncanny about him, like just the harmony, if that makes sense.
So
I think there was a picture of Wheat Waffles sitting next to, oh, I forgot. Well, it was First Man. Yeah. It was like that picture of Wheat Waffles and First Man at like some restaurant or something.
Yeah.
And I remember everyone in the comments, like women, were saying like the guy, like there was a couple black pillars in the comments saying, oh, they're both like looks matched or whatever. And then everyone, like all the females in the comments were actually saying like, no, the guy on the left, AKA this guy, Wheat Waffles, looks like a dork, while First Man looks like masculine and whatnot. So I think like, it is just like, there's harmony is a feature that is so overlooked in the black pill, like, especially with like people like Adam Driver, which I showed you, and like Ellen Rickman. And like harmony plays a big role in like things, even if you have all the individualistic features, like a good jaw, like you need all of it to kind of line up.
I agree. That's why I don't like the whole excuse with the nose. Like they use David Gandy and they say, oh, David Gandy doesn't have a great nose and he's like a supermodel, like, you know, and I'm like,
yeah,
okay, but he would look much better if he had a better nose.
Yeah, someone in the chat asked you what you thought of David Gandy's nose, by the way.
Oh,
like 20 minutes ago, I forgot to show the comment.
Yeah, let me see. Based on what I can see,
yeah, go on, sorry.
I'm not sure if it's shopped, but because some of those pictures, his nose looks straight, but I can see there's some asymmetry in it, and it's like non-photoshopped photos.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I think for some, he looks kind of like Adam Driver in a way, like Adam Driver with better bone structure. Some of these pictures. Actually, no, never mind.
Oh yeah, I'll show the. Let me see. Wait, Ganstar. What, so you, what do you rate David Gandy on the normal scale? Ganstar. Oh, I think he's fixing his mic or something.
Yeah. But yeah, he's like, I would say like, yeah, he has decent harmony. Obviously his nose is a little bit asymmetrical, which kind of throws it off.
Yeah. And obviously, like, just because he can get away with it, or like just because he can still get a high overall rating, doesn't mean most guys
can get away with it. That's like what I hate about like the whole like the Copers, like they'll say, like I think Tails talked about it, like wasn't there like who's that one serial killer guy they would say was a Chad? Was it the Night Stalker? Like Ted they Bundy? Would or, no, it was, fuck, I know his name.
Not the Buffalo Bill or
no, it was like the it was the Hispanic guy.
Shit, I don't know. Hispanic guy.
Richard Ramirez, that guy.
Oh.
So people will cope and be like, oh, well, he had bad teeth, so obviously teeth don't matter. And, like, they just do that with everything. Like, if they can find, like, a guy with good bone structure and just say, oh, well, this one thing is off, therefore, like, it doesn't matter. Like, you could do that with anything. Like, you could find a model with, like, negative capital tilt and say capital tilt doesn't matter. Like, it's just, like, kind of – I see things as a whole. So if the guy has, like, one major, like, bad point, but everything else is, like, average or decent, then overall he's good looking. But – or if it's, like, the – like, even Adam Driver, like, the harmony – like, his harmony is good, but, like, all of his individual features are bad. So but you can still see that there's a good amount of people that find him attractive.
Yeah, with David Gandy, I wasn't into say what I talked about on my video idea of the rating. Then I put him on the 6 to 6.5 because of his age. Like I just don't think he compete with like the younger male models now, like at the top level.
Yeah. Is that 6.5 on your scale or normie scale?
Oh, of course not on the normal scale. Like that's on my scale. So yeah, he would still be like considered like an age, you know, on the normal scale.
Yeah, I agree with that. Yeah.
But Richard Ramirez, I don't know. I can't see a universal amount of women like rating him high. Like I know he has amazing bone structure and all that, but I don't know, he just doesn't have that elite level look for me.
Bone structure alone is not like the be all end all.
Yeah, I know, that's exactly my point. I'm saying like just because he has one insane feature doesn't mean that he's just at the top because of that. Like some of these pictures, like I mean, like it's not.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like the black pillars will pick out. Like they don't understand. Like this guy obviously is a completely evil person, and he like committed a lot of crimes. And there's a niche amount of women that will like just that will like admire that. And like because I remember in his court like trial, there were people simping over him. But what black pillars see that, and they say, oh well, a handful of these, and they're all like mostly like unattractive women. So they'll say, oh, a handful of these sub 5 women were simping over him. Therefore, he must be a Chad. So they're like it's kind of, it's like a halo effect when they're rating him because they just factor that in, but they don't realize that, like if they see a handful of women simping over him because he's like a like done the worst things ever, that doesn't mean like all he's universally attractive. And that's I think a big problem of these guys.
I agree. Like it's not like you can say this guy and Jeremy Meeks, it's like, oh yeah, they're both like at the top level. Like Jeremy Meeks, you can say is much better looking than this guy overall, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, he fucking obliterates this guy.
they put him on the same level. They're like, oh yeah, Jeremy Meeks and Richard Ramirez, the two chads.
Yeah, that's
like,
not
oh
that's
no.
not true.
Jesus Christ.
Someone was saying that the true sign of like a legitimate like Chad, like a 9 or 10 out of 10, or even though it doesn't exist, is like if you can shave their hair and they still have some degree of appeal. That was
what's oh yeah, that's a good yeah. Like Tyson Beckford is bald and fucking mogs most people with full hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And he's old, he's not even in his prime anymore. I think Tyson Beckford is what, in his late 40s or at least mid 40s. It's not like he's 25. He like but yeah, him and Jeremy Meeks mog this guy to fucking oblivion.
Yeah, well, that's just a problem though, because you could literally get like a, let's say like a trousseau, right? And you could have like if a lot of women, like just ugly women on his looks level, said he was attractive, some of these black pillars would be like, oh, this guy's a Chad. Like they're completely disillusioned with like what actual people think.
Oh, Kendrick, that comment is from a woman, by the way. So we already have one woman. Oh.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. And all these black pillars, like I guarantee you, if Adam Driver went to Wheat Waffles or one of those guys to get a rating, they'd probably say like 4 or 3 out of 10, like because they just don't understand. Like they literally, all they'll do is they'll take measurements, which first of all, it's a sign of autism to just base everything off measurements. And second of all, like even though there's ideal ratios, obviously nature isn't completely ideal in every way. So there's exceptions where harmony definitely like outdoes a guy with all the right measurements, but he has horrible harmony.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I would agree. I would agree for the most part because, like, there was this one channel, he deleted all his videos, but called, what was it? Based Attraction or something like that. So he would just take Hollywood people and just do the measurements and give them an overall harmony score and all that.
I do remember that.
Oh, yeah? You saw it? Yeah,
I remember him because he had a different, like, he used a percentage, right? Like, instead of a rating out of 10, he would, like, give them final percentage out of 100.
Yeah.
She said Richard Ramirez isn't handsome, by the way.
Yeah, and that's there she just disproved what like 50% of all these black bullies are saying. So
he's a creeper. I agree. He is.
Yeah. I know, it's like, to me, like, he would almost be like a norm. Well, as the black would say, a normie, if it wasn't for the bone structure. I feel, you know, because of that, he is above average, of course. But there's just no way he's on the elite level.
And his teeth, like, his teeth were like correct. Like, his teeth were like literally rotting because he was like, he never brushed his teeth at all. And he was like on the run from the cops. Yeah.
Oh wow.
But these guys will still call him a Chad.
Oh yeah. Wait, Sean O'Brien, I don't know what you think of him, Ganstar, but someone brought him up too.
He's an interesting case because the black pillars would all call him like a Chad, but something about him, like in some of his pictures, look uncanny. Like, just like some people have said he looks like an alien.
He looks like a robot or something in some of these pictures. Like, literally. Like, he's not a Homo sapien. He's a fucking android.
That, I can see that. It's almost like too perfect in a way, like the measurements.
He's almost like a pretty boy version of Patrick Bateman.
Yeah.
Almost. Yeah, it's like he's missing a human element. Like, he has no soul. No offense, like, if he's watching this. No offense. I'm sure he's a nice guy.
I think the ones of him looking straight on at the camera, like, I think his gaze is too piercing, so that's why it looks like robotic almost. But because I could see the ones where he's like looking at an angle, like, where it look like he looks more attractive in those pictures.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Well, out of the people with that facial based attraction guy that was doing the percentages, I'll be curious what you would consider like someone like a prime Brooke Shields, because he put her on, I think, like 90%. He said that in her teenage years, she had like really good facial harmony and the measurements were almost perfect.
Yeah, I didn't see that. I remember I saw like his ratings were really interesting because they completely, like, because he factored in harmony, it completely went against a lot of these black pillars. Like, I remember he actually rated Andrew Tate like pretty high. Like, he rated him like, I think, somewhere around a 6, and all these black pillars, like, oh, well, he's a 4. So I don't know. That one's a little iffy, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I remember that one because I got a load of hate because I said Andrew Tate is like, I said he's like average to slightly below average, and they're like, he's like a 1 out of 10. What are you talking about? And I was like, you know, he does have some good features. Like, the guy who was doing that, he said like his lips are quite good, and some of the measurements as well kind of were adding up. So that's why he gave him like I said, a 6. I was thinking, okay, that's a bit high, but it was making me feel a bit better about mine because people were saying he was a 1. So I was like, oh, okay, well.
Yeah, no, he's not a 1. He's definitely not a true. So like, they're just coping because obviously like 3 and below is like you have to have a serious like deformity or like something on your face that's like completely like you're like you're balding at like 19 or something like that. Like, I don't really see how you like a 3. Like, obviously, when they say he's a 1, that's cope if they genuinely think he's a 1.
Yeah, that's
They think Fresh Prince of CEO of Fresh and Fit. They say he's like a 1 as well. When I said that he was like a bit below average, they're like, you're crazy. No girl's giving him more than a 1. I was like, come on, it's a bit harsh.
Yeah, I wouldn't say he's not a 1. Like, I'd put him at about a 4 something, I'd say.
Yeah, I said like a little below average. Like, yeah. Well.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say 4 is about, I'm trying to think, like, Alex PWF is around that same, even though it's hard to judge them both, but. I wouldn't put that, like, it's not like Fresh is a 1 and Alex is a 4. It's like they're both about.
Yeah.
And maybe, like, I feel like they're both within half of a point because Fresh is just.
Alex's photos look really good. There to draw from either. I'm assuming he uses like AI in his photos because his photos look like really good, but I'm not sure like how much of that is face up or whatnot.
No, what? It only a little bit, tiny amount.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, because I remember the one with.
Go on, sorry.
Didn't Indian PE like? Didn't he morph himself on another guy's body or something for the dating?
They both did.
Oh yeah, they both did. Yeah.
And they're trying to say that girls didn't notice apparently.
Nah, that's cope.
Yeah.
Well, Alex said for his one, he said he got 60% like success rate, so 40% of the girls were a bit like, oh, it's a bit too much. But then for Indian Pie Man, it was like 90%. So that 10% of girls weren't okay with it. So I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know about that because I feel like a lot of their practices are kind of disingenuous because they shouldn't even use Seeking because I wouldn't even count that because that's literally like a dating app for people. They're saying, look, I'm going to give you money to be with me. So right there, like, that's already factoring that in.
Well, what about this guy? This is a huge name in the community.
he is pretty, I'd put him pretty high because he has a very, obviously pretty much everything is ideal, I would say.
Yeah.
He looks like human.
Well, I think he looks a little bit like Zac Efron, I think, but like better looking.
Yeah, Zac Efron, like, I remember, that's why I like advocate against plastic surgery for some people, because as you can see, like, with Zac Efron before and after, like, if you go overboard on like that route, like, you can completely like mess up your face. And obviously, I think anyone will argue that he looks better before than he did now.
Yeah, totally.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is Looks for L's, like, man crush, kind of. So, Looks for L, I guess you can compare them or something. But, exactly.
Yeah, no, he's very attractive. Okay. Sorry. My internet's cutting out, so I can't hear you guys.
I'm going to just ask Ganstar what's his rating on the record.
Oh, yeah. I put Tom Lee, said he's like ace, 8.5 maybe.
Wait, on your scale or the normal scale?
Yeah, on the normal scale, I put him like an ace. Oh, no, sorry, on my scale, I meant to say. So, like, he's at the elite level, at the very top.
Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Okay.
Yeah. I would say, like, yeah, 9 on normal scale, like, pretty much the best. What makes him more human, in my opinion, is unlike the previous guy, like, his, like, you could, there's some asymmetry, but not significant asymmetry. So it just, like, aesthetically to the human eye, looks more like normal, like something you could comprehend better, if that makes sense.
Oh, yeah. It's just enough to let you know that you're a real person.
Yeah.
Well, that's like, I feel kind of bad now that we've been looking at these elite level guys and then we have to go back to the video, you know, of people who think they're at the elite level, you know, so.
Yeah. Well, I think, like, that's just insane, because when I go out in, like, daily life, like, a lot of, I see people that rate themselves, like, a 7, and, like, I obviously I'm not going to say it to their face, but, like, let's be real here, like, most people, you, like, in daily life are not that high, because, well, like I said, once you start at Chad Lighten Up, like, it's pretty rare to encounter those people.
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly. Like I say, most people are average, and then most people put on weight, too, to put them below average, so,
yeah. And especially if you're talking guys, not just women, like, because guys, a lot of guys think they're 5s, and I'm like, no, There are more 4s than 5s. I'm sorry. Like, even taking the weight stuff out of it.
Yeah.
They assume that the median is at a 5. Like, the absolute score, I rate on absolute score, but if we're talking, like, the median of who's walking around, I think a lot of guys assume, like, oh, I'm the average guy, so I must be a 5. And it's like, nah, bro, you're below average.
Yeah. And, like, I think what you say again, Star, I do agree with you. Like, a lot of women, like, even if you are objectively a 5, they'll consider you, like, a 4, like, or not even talk to you, because their standards are just ridiculously high, like, in nowadays.
Well, yeah, like, we have a girl in the community, Michelle, who was like nearly 300 pounds, and she gets like 1,000 likes in a couple of days.
Oh, yeah. Day, you know? And, it's insane, honestly.
And yeah, she was like saying that she only wants like 6'3", good looking guys. She had some other requirements too, like even like a huge penis and all that. So, you know, a girl like that is super picky. So what's a like average girl going to be like as well? You know?
Oh, yeah. No, definitely. Oh, yeah. I agree with that. Like, especially dating apps.
Yeah, yeah. Like, well, that's the thing I have with Brian on Chain, because I was saying, like, why is a girl going to want her looks matched when she can get guys way out of her league?
Yeah.
And he was like, going, oh, yeah, that's hypergamy. Of course that exists. But yeah, I still think guys at the bottom, can they get girls at the bottom? He's like, absolutely.
I was
like,
no. That well, maybe.
And he was like, I mean, if, like, yeah, go on.
Yeah, it's rare. It's rare for that to happen. Because I remember there was like, I forgot what, I don't know what it's called, but it was like the original like black pilling video where it was like an arranged marriage in India. And like they were just seeing each other for the first time. And like the girl, when she saw like who she was getting married to, she just had like the most disgusted like reaction. And,
oh, like, that's, I think I may have.
Yeah, you guys know what I'm talking about.
I can't remember what the. I feel like I've seen that though.
I've probably seen like all of them.
Yeah, it's just like really like obviously she was well above him in terms of looks, but like you were saying, like why would, because I've seen like women that are like slightly overweight, not like 300 pounds, but they're like they weigh more than I do. I'm like 150, and they will like they'll want people that are like at least like 6 or 7 out of 10s, and they'll get people that are 6 or 7 out of 10s just because of hypergamy, because it's so competitive. Most of these guys are desperate.
Wow. Yeah, like you know. Some people would say, like, this is literally some, like, red pill guys think this. They're like, oh, well, that girl's delusional. No, like, real good-looking guy would want her. And I'm like, yes, they would. That's how bad it is, you know?
Yeah.
Like, they may not marry her. They may not marry her. They'll be friends with benefits or something. Or,
yeah. No, well, like, that's just insane, though.
Or maybe the boyfriend-girlfriend.
Yeah, because, like, that's what some people are trying to tell me about Michelle. They're like, oh, you keep saying that about Michelle getting good-looking guys, but they're just using her for sex. And when I spoke to her, she's like saying, no, like she's the one in control. Like they're the ones like trying to like meet up more and like go on dates and things, like, trying to keep them more casual.
Yeah, they're
just like saying, that's like the biggest, like they say, cults in the community. They're like, oh yeah, these girls, they can get the good looking guy, but it's just for a night, you know, they can't get him to commit. But, like, you know, some of them can, you know?
Oh no, they can, that's for sure. I've seen, there's like a reality show where I remember it was like this obese woman that, but she was really wealthy and she literally had all these guys simping over her. Like they wanted a long-term relationship. It was almost like, it's like the opposite, like where the woman had all the money, but, and she was like morbidly obese, but she still had guys like simping over her. So like, wow. I just like, even these, like, they're just so desperate. Cause I've even seen like objectively, like I know a guy that actually is like a quote unquote pretty boy, as these guys would say. And they claim, oh, this guy slays, like, and he does, but he, like, the women he get with are noticeably like less attractive than he is, even though he's like supposedly like has a huge status and following.
Well, yeah, that's why I say it's like a hierarchy, you know, because people ask me about my dating, saying, oh, how come you can't get a girlfriend and all that? And I'm like, yeah, well, if I have to like date down like 2 points or something, I probably could, but if I want like my looks match or above, it's very difficult, you know. But people just say, no, man, it can't be that hard. Just need some game, you know. So
that's true. I will say the one thing, like, I would have like to say about your rating. I think your scale is just, I'm not blue pilled, but I think it's like a tad too harsh, because I do believe like hypergamy exists, but not to that degree. Because like obviously, like I would say I'm not even gonna rate myself, but, like, I'm like a high tier normie, and I can get like girls reliably that are like normie or a little bit above average. So I don't think it's as bad to where like if you're like a high tier normie, you're gonna get like 4s out of 10. But like I'd say it's like in, at least where I'm from America though, so it might be different where you're from. But here it's somewhat easier to get like a reliable relationship, where it's like where you don't have to like go dumpster diving.
And what like would be the means of obtaining those? Is it like just on at the bar or what?
I was telling Stefan, I was in a fraternity when I was an undergraduate, and they had like just parties. And if you were like moderately good looking, people would just approach you and they'd want to get with you. And I've seen a lot of things that, like, even on Black Pill, it's kind of made me question the Black Pill, because I've seen like guys where like the woman is like literally like 6'1" and the dude is like, let's say 5'7" and she was still with him because he was like very attractive facially. So I've seen things that have like made me like second guess what some of these guys are saying.
Well, I think that proves, well, I'm not going to say prove, but I think that proves that face comes first.
Yeah. I agree with that, but I've seen the opposite though, where there's like a guy that's like, I'd say he's like a 4 out of 5 facially, but he's like insanely tall. Like I think he's like 6'5", and he would still get girls just for his height. So I think it is like, I know that's like the mega cope and the Black Pill to say, oh, looks are subjective, but they are slightly, like, I think they're subjective, but not to the degree that like most people say they are. Like, obviously you could get two people that are 6 and like one woman would prefer one significantly over the other, even though they're both like objectively a 6.
Yeah. I mean, I have been rejected quite a bit based on my height.
Really?
So.
Yeah. I was gonna say though, like, it's completely unbiased. Like, I didn't even know why you're in the Black Pill sphere, because I'm like, dude, this guy, like, your lower third. I was talking to Stefan, I'm like, dude, your lower third's insane. Like, the hollow cheeks.
Well, I mean, yeah, I don't know. I just noticed that if I go outside, I might get attention. I will get some girls looking, but it's normally, again, like girls that are like below me, you know. And yeah, obviously, in the past, I have had my time where I have taken those options, you know. But mm-hmm. at this point, I don't really want to do that anymore. But you know.
Yeah. I respect that, because a lot of these guys would just like I think a lot of the PUAs do that, where like they'll just take whatever they can get, like if, as long as someone offers it, they'll take it.
Well, yeah, but they'll pretend like, oh no, but she was an 8 and I was a 9, like, you know, that's
yeah, I feel like whenever like they rate their, like, obviously like when they have to sell a product, so at the end of the day they're gonna be a little bit disingenuous, but yeah, I would say in like a lot of their ratings they'd be like, oh, I pulled, like, well, what was that one video I remember you guys were talking about? It was like on a date with like a curvy Latina or whatever, and he claimed she was like a Stacy or something like that.
Wait, what? Who said that?
It was, I remember it was on one of your guys' live streams. It was like, the video was titled On a Date with the Curvy Latina. And like, do you guys know what the video I'm talking about?
Oh, I can't remember. I remember that phrase exactly, curvy Latina, but I can't remember. Damn.
Because I thought it was something you were playing on, but no.
Oh, wait, real quick. What do you rate? Someone in the chat asked, what do you guys rate Quentin Dean? I think this is the right girl. I think.
Is it like a head on photo?
I
feel like she's like frauding with the bangs a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a fan, but I'm not going to rate her. I don't even care enough to rate her.
I feel like, you know, sometimes that's why I was saying with this whole thing with Mandana, which is ridiculous. Like, I do feel sometimes you need to play the person in motion to really get a perspective.
I agree with that.
Still image like this, you know, it's kind of hard to tell, but I'm going to say she's probably at most a 6, you know, but, you know, on a normal scale.
Yeah, I would even give her a 6, to be honest.
No, that's at most. 6.
Oh, at most. Yeah. Because I don't have any previous, like, knowledge of her, so I'm just going off. And some of these are, like, I can tell they're unflattering, so.
Yeah. That's why I think in motion she has potential to look above average anyway. But yeah, it's just, that's why with Matt Denden though, he's saying, no, you it's better to take a one picture and then change their ethnicity and that's how you rate them. It's just ridiculous.
Oh, and you actually saw I was just gonna say, man, Denden, you saw how he lied on Greg's stream and said that me and you rated Lisa an 8.
I thought he said a 9.
Well, both of us rated her a 7. And I think two of the Vlad, I think they still Vlad's and Noah said she was cute or something.
Yeah. And that's like, think about it. You should notice Kendrick, obviously. So we took like a dark skinned girl and we were saying, like, mm-hmm. yeah, in motion, playing on when she's on the TV, we said she's like a 7 on a normal scale. But then they were saying, like, man, she's average. And we were saying, oh, well, you probably just don't like dark skinned girls then, you know, because she is an objectively attractive dark skinned girl. And then this guy, Mandenden, he took a picture of her when she's like 14 or 15. And then he changed her ethnicity to like light skinned. And he's like, no, mm-hmm. I changed her ethnicity. So it's not the color. She's still like not that attractive, you know? And
we're
like,
well, that doesn't work.
Yeah, because obviously a dark-skinned person's going to have facial features which aren't going to be normal on a light-skinned person. So
that's like getting an Asian guy's photo and like changing his skin to be like dark. Like, it doesn't work. Like, this is different phenotype. You can't, like, because like obviously there's people, like, you could get a 6 from another country that has way, like, completely different facial features and bone structure, but they're still going to be like attractive, like, to the same woman as like someone else.
And Mandenden will nitpick certain features to justify his low rating, even though at the end of the debate he rated her like a 6 to 7 himself. So he was just lying all across the board, because, like, okay, you're defending Noah, who rated her a 4. Then you're lying and saying me and Ganstar rated her an 8. Then in our conversation to our face, you told me and Ganstar, you yourself rate her like a 6 or a 7 at best. So it's like, I don't know what, but his justification was, oh, her cheeks are too round or something. And I'm like, her cheeks aren't even that. Because I feel like, oh, and he said like her eyebrow spacing and all this other stuff. And it's like, bro, if that was like the white equivalent of her, you would be praising her, pedestalizing her, saying she's a Stacy Light or a Stacy.
Yeah.
Like, you would be sucking the fucking her toes while she's fat, bro. Because, like, I can see if her face was fat or something. Because I notice, and this is not just Mandenden, a lot of, like, white black pillars, they'll, like, exaggerate flaws if it's a black person. Like, take my nose, for example. my nose, which is like way better than like looks for L's nose or Greg's nose, because it's slightly flawed, they'll be like, oh, his nose is a little bit too big. Oh my God. But then if you take like a white person's that same feature and make it more flawed, they'll do the opposite and they'll try to like minimize it. Well, no, his nose isn't that bad, bro. His nose isn't that bad, bro. Like my eye space, they'll be like, oh, you could fit a football field between Stefan's eyes. His eyes are so far apart. It's like he's an alien. Whereas like people in real life barely notice it. But if you gave my eye spacing to a white guy, they would be like, what are you talking about, Ganstar? He's a Chad Light, bro. What are you talking about? Your eyes aren't that bad. It's like, bro, the bias is just so blatant and obvious. It's like, I would respect them more if they would just be honest. Because I've had like white friends that were like, yeah, this isn't my preference, but yeah, this girl is okay, but I'm not really into black girls that much. Or you know, I get it. But it's like, they'll just do this roundabout cope where they'll debate you for 20 minutes and then try to flip it on you at the end. Like, well, no, you guys are being biased because you only like black girls. You guys like dark-skinned girls. And I'm like, there's a difference between me liking black girls because I'm mostly black. Obviously, I'm like 70% black or whatever the fuck. But I've literally smashed every ethnicity of chicks except for Eastern Asian. That's the only type of woman I haven't had sex with. So just because I prefer black women, I guess, to an extent, and that like I don't go out of my way to like chase white women or chase these below average Latina or Asian women, that doesn't mean that I can't judge them. Like, again, if anybody would be a fair judge, it would actually be me. Like, who do you think is a fair judge of ethnic women? Someone like me who comes from a mixed family and has had sex with a bunch of different ethnicities of women, or a guy like Mandendon who barely leaves his house and he only smashes below average white women? Like, who do you think would be a better good faith, critic of ethnic women? I would think I literally have more experience dealing with, like, you know, and I like white women too. It's not like I don't like white women and I only like ethnic women. I literally lost my virginity to a white Latina. So it's like, it's like that's the biggest coup I've ever heard in my life. As you go on.
Yeah, but I actually want to talk to that guy because his views are interesting, like the Mandating guy.
Well,
I just wanted to like ask more about his views.
Well, no, like, I mean, look, he's a smart guy, but I just think with this, some guys with this, you know, community with the looks, like ratings and all that, I just think, like you said, some of them kind of get caught up in like some small details and then they like can't really give an overall valid score based on that. Like him saying that, like, that girl, her face is too round to be attractive, so she's average. And like this Norway guy gave her a 4 when he gives Natty like a 6. I'm like, it's like parallel universe. Like Natty
probably has
a single feature in her face which is better than Lisa from Saved by the Bell. So it's not even like, forget that. Like, he tried to say even the best one on Saved by the Bell, Kelly, he tried to say that she's like equal to Natty. I mean, wow. Oh, like, I can never forget that. Like, you know, I can't let him get over it. Like, you know, it's just, no.
Oh my God. Yeah. And then Noah's defense was, oh, but she has a nice body. If you don't like a Latina booty, then, or him and Alex both say this. Oh, if you don't like a Latina booty, then, you know, maybe that's why you don't like her, bro. And I'm like, bro, millions of Latina women have way better bodies than Natty. Her body is not that special. It's like,
that is something I wanted to bring up, Stefan, because I'm so sick of hearing this argument about, oh, but Natty has a hot body. She does not. I do not see that recent thing that she did. I didn't watch all of it, but I seen like small parts where, because I heard that she was in the video. Her body is nothing. It's like, I don't see anything. Just because some video she wears super tight jeans, any girl that isn't anorexic wearing those pants super tight is going to have some, you know, shape to her ass. You know what I mean? It doesn't mean that she's a hot body. Yeah. And oh my goodness. Look, no. Kelly has a better body than Natty. Like, what? I don't understand I'm missing here. You know what I mean? Like, Natty doesn't have, like the way Alex says, oh, I like huge tits. She don't have huge tits. You know what I mean? So how is Kelly's body worse than her? Kelly is actually in shape. Natty looks like she's pudgy and, again, just has to wear these super tight clothes to have any shape to her body.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, we'll pull that up later, I suppose. Okay, why don't we just finish this quickly, just because I'm sure people would want to see what he would rate, like Brian Unchained and all that. You're saying 6 is too high?
Oh, no. I think it's way too high. Like, because I just don't agree with his aesthetic.
Are you talking or no?
Yeah.
I can hear him.
Yeah, I would say with him, like, since he rate, I can rate all these guys in your video since they all, like, they've opened themselves up to it if they want to rate themselves. But I would say we probably, in this picture, I'd say a little bit slightly below average. And that's just because what's striking to me is his forehead. He looks like, I don't think he's receding, but the way he wears his hair like that, I just think it looks like he's almost accentuating the fact that his hairline is high, if that makes sense. And yeah, I just don't think his harmony lines up that much. That makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, in this specific clip, he's selling a $50 product. So this is like a 24-hour looks transformation. So this is him where he's saying, this is like my, you know, after result. This is what I'm...
Oh, wait, that's the after. Look.
Yeah.
I actually legitimately thought that was that one before, like the before, like when he said he looks mad, because I did see his website and it was like, didn't he say like 4 to 7 or something? Like some weird, like, and it was like more than 2 points.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm like, I thought that was the before. No offense to this guy, but I just don't think his harmony is on point. I think a lot of that, like I see some asymmetry, but overall, like, because he does have good, I will say he has good bone structure, but just something about his, that appearance just looks uncanny. I think most of it is owing to like the hair, because his, I think I told Stefan this, but his hairstyle like that he chose is really weird. And for like a self-proclaimed face raider and looks maxer, I'm like, well, wouldn't you want to choose a hairstyle that makes you look more attractive? But like, it almost looks like a wedge almost. Like, I just don't know why, like what motivated him to choose that hairstyle there.
It's going to be harsh when you get to me then, because everyone talks about my hair, but all good.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I just don't like, I think it's I have this friend of mine. She's also studying plastic surgery. If you guys think I'm brutal or Gantstar is brutal, like she rated Wheat right here at 2 out of 10, according to her.
That's my point. You know, people are saying, I say that he's like a 3.5, you know, and people, you know, they're saying that's crazy. He's like,
is that objective?
He's a 6, you know, so.
Like objectively, do you think he's a 3? Like what was your like rating of him on like the 1 to 10? Like,
on a normal scale, I said he's like average, maybe slightly above average on some clips.
Yeah.
He's average range for me. I wouldn't argue since you said slightly below, because like half a point, whatever.
Yeah, I would say virgin. I would say like 4.5 out of 10 on like objectively. The fact like we do have to factor in his phenotype. Because obviously it's just statistically, I don't have anything against gingers personally, but statistically, like women desire gingers a lot less than like if he was the exact same, but he had like black hair or something like that.
I think he said that gives him an advantage, I think, because he said, I make the deal and I can find the women that like that. So, yes.
Well, I mean,
yeah.
I don't agree with that person. I mean, because he, like, it's ironic because, like, I remember he uses statistics from OkCupid, and there's like statistics from some, like, a similar source as him that said gingers were the least desirable, like, race, or not race, but, like, the least desirable hair color in men. So, like, if you're going to use statistics from a certain source and, like, sell it as fact, like, you would have to consider all of it. So, I don't agree with that because there's also people that say, oh, well, if you're already attractive,
and you cut out for a second.
Oh, yeah, sorry. There's people that say like if you're already attractive and you should be a bodybuilder because you'll get even more girls, but it doesn't work like that because if you get too like if you do steroids like some of these guys are and get like too big almost like to where it's unnatural, you'll actually decrease the amount of women that are attracted to you. So that's by saying, oh, well, because I'm ginger, I'm unique. Like you could argue that, oh, because I'm a true cell, like no one looks like it doesn't really like, hold up, if that makes sense.
Because I'm a true cell, I'm unique. Well, imagine.
No, yeah, it's like saying, oh, no one else has like a guy with no chin. He's like, oh, no one else has as much recession as I do. Therefore, I'm unique, and you're unique, but not in a good way, if that makes sense.
Oh wow. Well, okay, yeah. When I'm rating people, I try not to include like ethnicity. I just try to look at objective facial features. So like with Hamza and stuff, like I don't add in that he's, you know, his ethnicity. I just say facial attraction wise, I just give him an overall. But, so if I was adding in the ginger, then he probably would be below average. So I would agree with people.
The one reason I do use ethnicity on him is because see how his like eyebrows are so light, so it almost looks like he has very faint eyebrows, so it kind of like it just looks weird almost like it almost looks like it looks more of like a shadow. So that's the only reason I'm kind of factoring that in, because it actually does make a difference, because a lot of people underestimate eyebrows and like how much that can change your appearance.
Yeah, I said that on my looks maxing video too. I said that the eyebrows are definitely underlooked. Like it can definitely, I'm not saying they can change your face, but it can definitely be a multiplier, you know, if they're shaped correctly. With Wheat Waffles, even Chatify, we're sort of friendly, I suppose. So yeah, like he agreed that if he darkened his eyebrows, it would definitely make a decent improvement. So yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't. I don't think in any world that he's a 6.5 out of 10. Like put it that way. I'd say even like I wouldn't say 6 personally. But definitely like I would not say 6.5 because that's verging on Chad Light territory. I do. I will say this.
Yeah,
this is Lightfuel. I do think Lightfuel for Greg. I think Greg mogs him.
Well, he's not going to take that as a compliment. I already know that. He would just say that. So.
Oh, okay. I'm not really sure
how he was that high either. So, but we get to the next part and see he jumps it to 7 to 8. So let's play that part.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, well. Okay.
He looks even worse than those.
Damn. There.
Okay,
we go.
That one, yeah.
Wow.
I would say that one, he does look, I would rate him like, maybe like a 5.5, because he does look better in that one significantly, because I think he's squinting and whatnot.
Yeah, of course, yeah. No one's going to deny that he does.
But maxing works, people.
I would not say he's a 7 or 8 out of 10, because if we're going to rate people, like, we're going to rate actual celebrities like 7 or 8 out of 10. Like, that's what I don't understand about these guys' ratings, is if you rate two people a 7, and one of the people you rated is significantly more attractive than the other, like, two 7s can't exist if one's more attractive than the other. It has to be, like, one has to be higher than the other.
Well, yeah, I said that multiple times in my videos, because people try to tell me like he's super high in movie stars. They're like, oh yeah, this guy's also an 8. Like, well, okay, actually, I had this issue with Stefan a while back because he was rating Kevin Way Wilder like an 8.
Oh yeah.
And I was like, how can you rate him that? If that's movies. I can't remember exactly. You said like an 8.
It was you said he was a 6, and I said 7.
Oh, was it? Oh,
wait, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh yeah, no, because remember, You gave some example and you were like, oh, if so-and-so is a seven, then Kevin Ray Wilder is in a seven. But remember, I wasn't really black pill back then. That's why when I changed my opinion, that's why I was like, oh shit, Ganstar was right. He makes like, I get it now. But well, I think people, they need a time to go through. Like I think when you're used to like rating and then you're black pilled, like you don't instantly get good at rating. It's like, you need to like, I mean, it didn't take that long, but I felt like around that time I kind of adjusted and I was like, oh, okay, I get it now. Okay. Like I'm overrating by a point or whatever it was.
Yeah.
Most people just keep on rating the same way.
Yeah. That's what Wheat does, I think, because I see like the people, I think he changes it. His scale is so dynamic because he changes it. Like the people he rated a seven like 2 years ago, he would rate them like a five or four if you resubmitted the photo. So what was the name of the guy he rated that was like notoriously like a horrible rating? That one like balding guy.
Oh, why? Like, I remember Julian,
right? Yeah, that guy. Yeah. Like the
guy he rated a seven. RSD Julian, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I actually remember that, yeah. And he rated some Asia by a seven as well, if you saw that, Stefan, do you remember?
Oh, yeah,
Chang Nation, yeah. And Tails rated him like a 4.75.
Yeah, that's the thing, though. Everyone says, like, Tails is brutal and stuff, but I've seen Tails actually, like, factor in harmony, like, because these guys, I think, they don't really have, and that's what kind of irks me about these guys, is they claim to be these face raiders, and they don't have any experience, like, in any aesthetic field. They just say, oh, I watched, like, 2 hours of YouTube videos that show that I can analyze bone structure, therefore, I'm like, what I say is law, and I just don't really agree with that. Like, if they're going to give you a rating, I think I told Stefan this, but, like, why don't you go to, like, a legitimate, like, plastic surgeon, or even a woman that can, like, give you an accurate, unbiased rating? Why would you go to one of these guys who don't really know what they're talking about?
Well, their excuses, like Wheat Waffle said, oh, I've rated over 1,000 faces now, so I'm like super experienced. You know,
he's given incorrect ratings to 1,000 faces, therefore he's more accurate than. Yeah, I see. Exactly. That's like that. If you really look into what the statistics they're saying, like just because I could say, oh, I've done this 1,000 times, it doesn't mean I'm good at it if I'm not paying attention or I'm not like doing something incorrectly. But like I would say in this picture, back to the video, there's no way he's a seven or eight, because a seven out of eight, we're seven or eight, we're talking about like actual like Chads like that. Like I would say like a legitimate like seven or eight would probably be like Damian Carter, one of those guys, and obviously they mog Wheat Waffles.
Oh, well, I don't know if you've seen this video, but I obviously touch on that at the end, so you'll see when we get to it. But yeah, okay. I'm basically everything you said there is going to come up, so you'll see.
Okay.
Okay, so I guess we can move to Brian Unchained, Stefan.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, analyze Kendrick.
I think he's noticeably.
Yeah, go on.
He's noticeably better looking than the first guy, like Wheat Waffles, because I would say like he has a little more like aesthetic sense, since he is using like, obviously they make fun of it, but they like the mushroom haircut. But I do think it helps his overall aesthetic. I don't think he's an 8 out of 10 if he legitimately thinks that. Obviously, like I said, that's like, we reserve that spot for like some, like your face has to be almost flawless, like everything. But yeah. I would say face alone, obviously his overall SMV is high because like he has a good, he's lean and stuff, but I would say just face alone, I would give him like maybe like a mid, like a 6.5 or maybe seven. It depends though, okay. Like on the normie scale. But yeah, overall, like I don't like, there's nothing like striking. Like I wouldn't say like Chad Light, there's nothing like striking. Like, but overall, I would say most, like women would perceive him to be more attractive than a majority of like the people you see in normal life.
Yeah, no, he's definitely above average for sure. I'm never denying that, even though I asked him, I'm not gonna lie. No, I think he's a decent looking guy, but I just don't think he's at the elite level like he says he is, you know. But,
he's not Nate, that's for sure.
Yeah, and that's the thing, like, see, this is why I did these videos in motion, because like he can take some pictures and he like laddering angles and lighting and he can look a lot better. I'm not, you know, so I'm saying it's some of those, some people do think he looks like an eight, whatever they want to say. But when you see him in motion like this, it's just way more accurate to give an actual, you know, valid score. And like you're saying, you're watching him speak and move, and you're saying you don't see an elite level guy. So I think that's a lot more accurate.
Yeah.
Approach. Okay. That's all good. I guess we can move on to chat, though, I guess.
Okay.
Goodness, this is so harsh.
Yeah. So I could see that this guy would, I could see him having some appeal. He has like kind of like the surfer appeal, I guess, because he has a good phenotype. I'll say like his eye color. Let me try. I remember because Tails made a video on him. I still wouldn't say. Like I wouldn't say he's an 8 out of 10. Like I said, that's still reserved for like the highest of the high. But I don't know. He's kind of hard because. Like you were saying, Ganstar, I was gonna say like around like the same levels as the Brian Chain guy, but I would say he does look, to me at least, he looks slightly better than the Brian guy because his jawline. But I don't know, because he has good harmony and whatnot. I would say, see, in that, for some reason in that shot, like when he's smiling, he doesn't look as good in my opinion.
Yeah.
Like it just looks like his jaw looks too pointy almost. that makes
it
sense.
Almost depends on, it depends on which shot yeah. you're looking at.
That's true. I'd say definitely Brian's body's better than his. In that, yeah, he's kind of an interesting one because the longer I look at him, like the more I can see, like even though he has, and black belt is automatically like, oh, he has a good jaw, therefore he must be an eight or whatever. But I think something about his jaw just kind of like, it's almost like his chin is too pronounced in my opinion. Like it's it just looks almost like a point kind of, like it narrows too much. He is obviously noticeably more attractive than the majority of the population. I would say I'd give him a 6.75 objectively, because most people would rate, like if it was a black belt, they'd rate him similar to Brian and Chained, but I think just some of his features are more striking, like his eye color, and like I like his hairstyle, like the longest like surfer hair. So I'd say like 6.75 out of 10.
Okay. I guess it's not too bad. he wouldn't like it, but
that's good, honestly. That mogs literally like 80% of the population, I think.
Yeah, I know exactly. Okay, I guess I think looks for us next. So,
oh yeah,
let's see. Yeah, I think he looks the best in that clip that we had up there.
Yeah,
that's why I try to get multiple shots of the guy.
Oh, that's a bad lighting in my opinion. But...
oh yeah.
Yeah, can you pause?
Oh, there's Greg.
You see, with him, it's just he never cams up. So these are the only clips I can get of him. You know?
Yeah,
so that's why.
I would say that. Yeah. That lighting is like really bad because it obviously like makes his face look pale, like he like almost like he doesn't have like melatonin or something. But obviously, I know that's just the lighting.
Yeah, I've seen
that picture.
He
does. Yeah, like in that shot, he looks really good. But I'm not really sure. Like I said, it's going to be like harder to rate him since those are like the only footage of him.
Yeah. He does have a really bad nose. It's not so easy to tell here because he does a lot of like side face shots, but his nose is quite bad, and he's one of those guys that uses that excuse as well, that oh, the nose doesn't matter. But
I keep telling him, I would rate him like 6.
Whoa, really?
Wow.
He's not gonna like that.
Oh man.
Well, just because like I don't know, like based on what I could see so far, like I didn't like the camera angle, or because like all you can really see of him are like a 3-4 shot, and then in that one like a side shot. So he doesn't like, since there's not a front on shot, it's kind of hard to like rate his like symmetry and harmony and whatnot.
Yeah, he does that on purpose because he doesn't want to show his nose off from the front because he knows it's bad. Yeah. So he does that deliberately.
Yeah, well, that's because then he's like, it makes it hard too. And I've noticed that like sometimes when they try to fraud, it actually looks worse than if they would have just had a front on shot, because it just doesn't look like I would change the lighting. But based on what I've seen, I'd give him a 6 because I don't really know like what he looks like from the front.
Stefan, can you try to do that where he's like shaking his head? You can just see if he can kind of make out anything, if it's possible. Yeah, the first clip, he starts like shaking his head. You can, pause on the right moment, you might catch his phone.
Oh yeah, I could see what you're talking about, where his nose was like oddly shaped. Yeah, so I'd still say around 6, because you could kind of like from the side profile, you can kind of notice that like there's something, like there's like a bump in the middle of his nose. I'd give him like a, maybe because of that, like a 5.75.
Oh wow. Greg is going to love this. God. Oh my god.
Greg is actually going to, he's going to like my stream now.
Well, people don't realize, like objectively, let's say even 5.5, like if you're a 5.5, you're in the top, like the top 33% of the entire like population.
Literally.
Like that's what these people don't realize. Like there's true cells that would kill to be like you.
Yeah, I know, exactly. And, but like he thinks again, like he's at the elite level. He says like 7.5, maybe 8. Like he thinks at the top.
He adds in the height because he's like 6'3" in shoes.
Yeah, that would boost his SMV a lot.
Yeah,
like it with the height is probably 6. Well, actually, I can't say that. Well, it's like SMV is like 6.75, but face alone, I would say just like whatever, 5.75 or 6, depending on like if he had good lighting or something. Maybe I would change it though. So I'm not sure. Yeah.
Well, I think that he says 7.5, but with the height, he'd say probably 8, something like that. Same with Brian on Chain. Yeah. He says his face is 7.5, but with height, he gives himself an 8. So
I'm not sure about 8, though, because if we aren't factoring in percentages, I think an 8 out of 10 would probably be, like, under, like, if you're going by random standard deviation, it would probably be, like, under, like 2%. So there are a lot of, I would say there's more than 2% of guys that are, like, his height and, like, have, like, a more attractive face. So I'm not sure if I could say that.
Yeah, and he just thinks because, he has a good jawline, and he thinks his eyebrows are, like, proportionate and stuff, and his hair is, like, the style that girls are, some girls are into. I guess he thinks he has a good eye earlier and all that. So he's like, well, how can I not be? Because like the eyes and the jaw are the most important. So
yeah, yeah, that's what a lot of these guys fall down. They're like, well, because jaw, like they even say that like jaw is law. Yeah. I that's not completely true. Obviously, a good jawline fixes like it's. I would choose to have a good jawline over a mediocre one, but it's not like everything. Like there's still like I said, even they even call it lower third. There's still two thirds of things that you have to consider. So
exactly, yeah. I know. And that's why I say to him with his mid face is obviously he admits it, but he just thinks like, oh, for men it's not that important though. So he says, I have the important part, so that's what matters.
Yeah.
So, but to be at the elite level, you'd want those things to be on point too,
Yeah, literally everything has to be like almost perfect to be on that level.
And then he brings up David Gandhi all the time saying, oh, David Gandhi doesn't have a perfect nose and mid-face. So,
yeah.
Like, you're not David Gandhi, so.
Yeah.
Well, David Gandhi's nose is not as bad as his either. So that's why I told him that as well. But he doesn't really well. He said he'd consider rhinoplasty at some point, maybe. But
he could do it, honestly. Like, I'm not sure like how wealthy these guys are, but rhinoplasty, it's not really that much. It's like one of the cheaper procedures, I would say, from like what I've seen.
Well, after you said this, verdict of the score, I'd say he's probably considering it right now. So,
he could get he could probably get a good rhino for like 5,000 to 7,000, which I'm not sure. Are these guys do they pull in a lot of money from like selling their?
Well, I mean, he's a poker player, so maybe he does.
He doesn't have money. Like, come on, he wants everyone to pay for him and all this. So,
okay, well, if he can get together, I'd say he could get a pretty good rhinoplasty for around 7,000. From a reputable surgeon. So I would say overall, put it this way, if I were to have something wrong with my nose or my eye area, I'd choose nose 9 times out of 10 because it's just, there's less risk involved and it's a lot easier to fix.
Good to know.
Yeah.
Goodness, that was definitely the most interesting rating so far. I mean, next is Greg. Look, you can just look at the clips. You don't have to give a verdict if you don't want, but maybe you want to go over some features, you don't have to say an overall score, but
Yeah,
I mean, nobody in this video is like a sub-5, so I mean, it's not like
they're all above average. Like,
It's not like you're judging me versus Waffles.
Waffles is the exception.
Yeah, I'm sorry, there was one.
We just kind of coping with that. Like, there's no way in hell he's a 7.5 or 8 out of 10. Like, that's I would say all these guys. Like, I haven't seen the rest of the video, but so far these other two guys mock him. So there's if I'm rating this guy, for example, a 6, and Wheat says he's a 6, like that, you can see how that just doesn't add up. Like, obviously, one has to be more attractive than the other.
Well, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay, all good. Suppose we move on to Greg Lorick.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, so right there, I would advise Greg to change his hairstyle a little bit. That one. I'm not a big fan of the haircut, but I do see positive features. I think he has good harmony there, but like the hair is just throwing it off a little bit.
Well, he has to lay his hair down like this because his hairline is receding on this side.
Oh.
I mean, not in this video, but I've already, before my other channel was terminated, there were still shots of his hair or whatever.
I like the one, if you go back a little bit, the one, he had a still shot of him. Not that one. It's a little bit. Yeah, that one.
Wait, let me see. Hold on. I think, you can't really tell there either, but you see, it's weird.
Facially though, face alone, obviously some people would say his body is not up to stand, but I'd say his face in that one picture, you could kind of see the makings of high cheekbones, I would say. That
with this one?
Sorry?
What was the picture that you're trying to get to? This one?
I would say his face looked good in the one before the clip of him boxing.
Oh, this one?
Yeah. I would say his face, in terms of just face only, I would say, because you can see how it's kind of the light, but see how you can see he has high cheekbones in that one.
Wait, Gans, this is the face app.
Oh, well. His eye is.
Damn, that's so harsh. Damn.
I'm not sure.
What did you rate? I'm sorry. I didn't. I was laughing. I laughed over you. I didn't hear.
Oh, I just said he had his eye area looked good in that one, but I'm not sure if it's face app or not.
Yeah, it's face app.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Is there one of them that's confirmed that it's not face app?
Yeah, no, the rest is him. Just like that's I only use that picture to show his physique, But, yeah.
Yeah, this is clearly not face app.
Okay.
Because he's used filters on his speed dates as well.
Oh.
And some of his meet me dates or which I guess aren't real speed dates, but whatever. Kind of like Omegle. But on these car videos, that's what he actually looks like.
And this, it's just for me, everything else is decent and above average, but just the hair, it's kind of like, I don't know, just that one hairstyle.
Like holding him back.
Yeah, I would advise him to change the hair because it would accentuate
his there goes the receding thing on the corners, kind of.
Yeah, okay, I can see. But I think there's still other ways for him to do his hair that because there it just kind of looks like a bowl cut on the front almost. But But I would say, like, if Greg, if you're watching this, I would say you have like all the, like, your hard features. Like, for me, if someone insults my hair, it's not bad, because like that can, when someone says eyebrows are bad or hair is bad, that's actually good news, because that can be changed in a matter of like a month, just growing your eyebrows or hair out. But I would say like in terms of hard features, he does have a good, like, he has a good jawline in my opinion, because there's like one of them where's like a side shot, so he does have like a good lower third.
So I'm kind of curious, because obviously if you're giving Luke Farrell like 6 or 5.75,
yeah,
are you going to give Greg a higher rating than him?
He thinks he destroys Greg,
you know, he thinks
that he's way better. I can PM you guys what I would rate him. I've seen these guys like get really angry at each other, like over ratings and like dox each other and stuff. So
if you don't feel you don't want to give him those scores, fine.
I can tell you after what I would rate him.
Yeah, but no, because he's going to ask, you know, after. So I probably better not know if you don't want him to find out, because he's going to ask me. So yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, you can tell me, obviously. He's not going to ask me, but he definitely would ask Ganstar. So.
Okay. Well, if he is, I'm assuming he is watching this, because I think you guys watch each other's streams. But yeah, I would say like just everything, like his features are like above average. I'll say that confidently. Like, I'm definitely above average dude, but just the hair is my opinion. He should change that.
So the curved nose is the only real flaw as far as I don't think the eye area is terrible. I just think he overrates himself. I don't think it's terrible.
Yeah, that one you showed me in that last stream where like it was like his, like he was in the car, like taking, like it sort of showed his side profile. His jaw looked good in that one.
I'm not sure. Yeah. Like, you mean the where he looks kind of like a bone smasher, where he's
sticking his chin. Like, that jaw looked good there.
Yeah. I think he was frauding a little bit in that one, because his jaw, like in all of these moving pictures, his jaw doesn't look as good as it did in the picture I sent you.
And I remember like the long time ago when he was complaining about what we rated him a 5. He had like a TikTok. That's how I first saw Gray, actually, like a year ago on TikTok. And I remember he was talking about his wheat waffles rating. I think his hair looked good in that video he made. I don't know. I don't think we can find it, but his hair looked better. Like, I'd prefer that hairstyle over this one if I was a girl.
Yeah. I mean, overall though, I don't think he could complain, you know, because you have been quite fair with him. And
I'm being objective. I just don't want to provide like a rating, because I know the other, like the first three guys in wheat waffles, like, I don't think they're going to watch this, or hopefully not.
Yeah, no, they're not
going to. Okay.
They don't know my channel even exists. I mean, Brian technically does, but Wheat Waffles does too, technically, but they're not, I mean,
I don't think like they're going to take time out of their day to like find it.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Especially considering I only have like 50 subs now, so.
The only reason I don't want to like rate Greg is because I know he's like an active viewer of your channel, like you guys watch each other's, but yeah, I can like give him like tell him features and stuff. Like I could tell him, like I would say like if you wanted to, we could get a run, because like what he has, like the, he has, I forgot what it's called, like that like hump on his nose or what, I forgot what that's called. I should know that, but that's pretty easy to fix. Like with the, like overall, I'd prefer to have that kind of a nose over like the other guy's nose, because it's relatively easy to like it's minimalistically invasive.
Oh yeah, I can see that.
He's the best. The same as looks for, like, you know, it's from the front, so his doesn't look so bad compared to looks for L. That looks better on the side. Greg's looks worse from the side.
Yeah, because from the front it seems like mostly like straight.
Yeah, from the front it's really not that. It's definitely better than looks for L's from the front, that's for sure. Because the curve you can more, it's like a bird beat curve, so you would kind of have to look at from the side to notice. Looking straight on, you can't really.
I actually had a question for you guys, because what, like a lot of people, like there's some people that say like side profile is the most important, and then there's some people that say front profile is the most important. Like, if you could choose hypothetically, would you rather have like a really good front profile and like horrible side profile, or vice versa?
If I had to choose between the two, I would choose to have a better like front on.
Yeah, that's exactly what I say, but there's some of these guys that are saying, oh, side profile is everything, but in my opinion, like the only time. Yeah, because like the only time you really see side like how, like think about it, how often are you talking to someone and like you're staring at their side, like it's only when you're driving or something that
I think like it's not that it's not important, but I think it's more so, because I heard someone's argument was the side profile is more important because most of the times out in the world when people see you, like in the wild, they're seeing you at an angle, like they're across the street, or they're like behind you, so they're walking around. So like I get what they meant, but it's like at the end of the day, for people who are actually interacting, most of the time they're going to look at you from the front, or at least from like a diagonal from the front.
I agree with that, because like I'm talking about like, you know, like how that like complete like profile shot where it's like
from the like a perpendicular angle, like
the chance, like usually most people aren't going to get a good look at you from that angle, but I've noticed a lot of black pillars cope and say that's all that matters.
That's a reach. That's good. A hell of a reach right there.
I would definitely choose the front, but I would say a good example of that is like Jessica Alba, who has like a really good front of you but a very bad side portrait. So again though, like I would still take her frontal over the side, you know. So because most people think about it, she has a really bad side, but most people don't notice. You know, it's only if you go on a picture and you see it, you're like, "Oh wow, I didn't realize it was that bad." Because most people are going to observe her from the front, so that's definitely more important.
I'm going to go for about like 30 seconds if that's chill.
Oh yeah, definitely.
All right, I'll be right back.
So Stefan, after this, do you want to do the Playing with Fire videos?
Oh, yeah, yeah. The short guy.
Oh, goodness. I read the comments, yeah, so I know that people are saying that he got some good results. But yeah, I'm definitely curious to hear your analysis of that.
Oh, man. Yeah, I think I didn't see the whole video, but the few minutes I saw were actually pretty good. He might have better game than Alex, to be honest.
No. Oh, my goodness. I read the comments, right, that Indian Pie Man, he was saying, imagine if I coach him next time and we do another video. And people were saying, oh, yeah, but they're like, I thought he was quite solid. Like, I would have thought he was at least equal to you. And he was like, no, I can see a lot of errors. And I understand because I used to do the same. But I have a very good eye for this now since I'm an expert. Oh my goodness. I just want someone to shut him up. Because ever since he left, you know, that he was out of the community for a while. He's come back now and he's trying to act like, you know, all that stuff that came out about him didn't happen. He's like, oh, I'm an expert in roles now. Yeah, my credibility is back. You know, and I'm like, no one forgot what happened. You know, just because you blocked everyone doesn't mean that's just going to go away.
Oh, my God. Yeah, he blocked literally everyone.
Yeah, and that's the thing with Mandendon too, and Alex Hader. They're also complaining about people. You know, obviously, I think some people saw when I gave out about Mandendon not calling out Alex about the whole thing with Myron.
And
they're doing the same thing. They're going, oh, it's not up to us. Go find someone else to debate. You know, we don't have to do it all the time. Like, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Like, but if you're literally there. Watching him talking trash, why not call him out? You
know? Yeah, Alex Hader said, because somebody asked him, I think, to debate him or to get on the panel, and Alex Hader said he's done enough already or something.
I've seen him say that as well.
I mean, I get it, because I think Alex Hader doesn't take the black pill shit as serious. Like, he's more of like he knows Alex is stupid, but he doesn't take it as serious as Mandendon, so I can kind of see his point, kind of, because Alex Hader, it seemed like he's more so there to just like make jokes and like kill time, whereas Mandendon, we know how serious Mandendon takes this stuff.
Like Alex Hader says that, I think I saw him text saying that, oh, I do enough in his chat. Don't you see me always calling him out there? Like, you know, but I'm like, well, when he's on the panel with you or when you're in the chat while he's on the panel where he will actually address the questions, why not say it then? You're only doing it when you know he's not going to say anything back, you know? So,
yeah.
I can't stand that. But, Kendrick, you back? Or?
Yeah, I'm back.
Oh, yeah. All good, all good. Okay, look, we just finished the video quickly, so then we can move on.
Yeah, we've only got one more.
Well, and then we have the actual elite people, so... So Kendrick, I'm eager. You can be as harsh as you want. It's all good.
Okay. I did that friend I was playing about earlier with Blue. I did ask her like rating people, and she actually, believe it or not, like she rated you a 7, and like I did not give her any information about who you were. She did say that she doesn't like the, like, she likes the one where your hair is down, and I would agree. Like I forgot, like that one for example.
Yeah.
Like, so she said that. She said like you have a good, like she liked the hollow cheeks look. She trying to see what else. Like, she just didn't like the one where you, like, your hair was up all the way, but she'd say overall, like, bone structure and whatnot is pretty good.
So she didn't like
it. Like, it's super harsh.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That's like, she's the one that rated Weeda too. So she's like, not like, she doesn't inflate anything. So, yeah. She rated you a 7. Let me see. Wow.
Maybe take off that was probably the worst angle. Then.
Yeah. See, like, that one, I just, like, yeah, I'm not a big fan of that, but I think those, like, that's a good look, I think. Like, the hoodie. Like, where it has, like, that's kind of like what the TikTokers try to do, is they'll have like their hair down and they'll have like a hoodie over it. So I think that looks good.
And like the one, yeah, like, is good.
Yeah, the physique's definitely like that. Just that's like high, way higher SMV. But yeah, I'd say like I would have to say around the same, like probably just like 7.
Okay. Well, like, you know that guy Brian Unchained, right? I mean, look, I'm not saying I'm better looking than him, right? I've never said that. But he obviously thinks he destroys me. Like, he gives himself an 8, he gives me like a 5.
No, there's no way you're a 5. I mean, that means, like, by that logic, you're, like, I put it this way, I don't really see anyone that looks like you when I go outside. Like the 5, if that was true, then I'd be, like, everyone would look like you. That's cope, obviously. I will say, like, confidently, you mog all the other guys in the video so far.
Maybe
Chad Pill would be more appealing to, like, younger people, like, maybe 18, 19, 20, but overall, I would say you mog most of them.
I mean, he's the last one in the video. I'm not saying this. I just want to hear your perspective, because everyone I showed in the video, they all think that they're better than me. The only person who puts me ahead of some of the other guys is Greg, because he doesn't like the other guys. So he puts me ahead of them. But he doesn't put me ahead of him, though. He thinks that he's a little better.
Yeah. Completely biased.
But everyone else, like Luke Farrell, Chadfield, Brandon Chain, they think they're like a lot better than me, like by a good amount of points, you know?
No, I couldn't say that, because I think you have the best bone structure out of all of them. Like, in terms, like the only person, like I said, that even comes close to your lower third is probably the Chad Peel guy, but I think you have a better lower third because his was like kind of narrowed down, like tapered to a point, but you have like the ideal, like wide lower third.
Yeah, well, that's true.
Like, okay, same thing, right? With the whole people say, you know the way that my look, my cheeks appear like kind of like hollow here. They say like, oh, you're sucking them in. But you see the way my mouth is open. Oh, like how am I sucking them in? Like,
when you talk, I've seen your videos. When you talk, it still has that. So if that was
true, even when he's resting, it is. He always has that. Like, throughout, like whether he's talking or not talking or like,
Well, like, that's what James was trying to say. Like, oh, you, I can't take you serious because like every second you're sucking your cheeks in. Like, you know, and I'm like, you can't. Like, I show men's maxing. But when his mouth is open, men's maxing doesn't happen because he can't suck it in. But like, that's why I showed a video of me and him comparing it, saying, look, when my mouth is moving while I'm talking, it's the same, you know? So.
No, I agree. I would say that, yeah, I think they're just coping, obviously, because I joked about this to Stefan, but I said, like, before I knew you, I'm like, you literally have like a 240p camera and you still mog like these guys, like, they're like trying hard and like,
and stuff. Angle frauding and everything.
Yeah, but like, you're just literally just talking into like a camera and you still mock them. So yeah, I would have to say, like, because that's why originally when I saw your video, like,
and he doesn't have a nose. He doesn't have a nose feeler like the others.
Yeah, I feel like when I originally saw this mog battle, I actually thought it was like satire, because like, I thought it was pretty apparent that you mog most of these guys. No, or all of them actually. But
wow, well, like, even Stefan, I read the comments, Stefan, you put me like third lowest or something, right?
Really?
But I think I was talking the SMV.
No, I mean, look, again, I've never said that I'm better than Luxfarel, I'm better than these guys, but...
Because I don't do face ratings unless that's specifically, like, if someone asks me.
Yeah.
Like, generally speaking, I just judge the...
Well, I think I read a comment from someone, and they said that Wheat Waffles is better than me because...
No, that's cool, that's cool.
But they're saying because he's white and I'm mixed race, so, like, he's a better ethnicity.
He's ginger, though. Like,
I know. Exactly, but yeah.
No, that's a coper, obvious, because I remember I sent Stefan it, but there's a literally screenshot of someone that wrote like an entire dissertation about like saying like that, like, just because someone has ideal, because like, it was like that Wheat and First Man, they're like, First Man mogs Wheat, and all the people that are saying he doesn't don't have any idea of, like, it's not like, they basically say you can't learn facial harmony off like 4chan or YouTube and stuff. So no, you definitely mog Wheat, like, facially. I'm not sure, actually, I wasn't fat, maybe like factoring SMV, like height and everything. Some of those guys would mog you, but I don't know. Like, I'm not sure. How tall are you, if you don't mind?
Yeah, I'm 5'9". No, their height is definitely going to be a lot more appealing than mine. I'll agree with that, of course.
But I'll say, like, facially, though, like, you mog them. Like, if we just take all, like, height, even body, though, because I think, like,
clearly, yeah, I agree with that, yeah.
Well, some people might say, like, it's like the bodybuilder look, but I would say, like, I'm not sure if you're, like, natty or not, but I would definitely say, like, your body's one of the best.
Because I think Ganstar doesn't focus too much on bulk. He like, has the lean look instead of. Like, he's not overly stocky, like an NFL linebacker or some shit.
Yeah, I agree with that, because I would say maybe it was the Brian Unchained guy who had like the kind of like lean aesthetic. Like,
oh yeah, that was him.
Like, some women might prefer that, but some women might prefer like your body. So I can't really make a verdict on that. But I would say facially you do. Like, I could confidently say like you would mog most of them, or not all of them. I don't know. I keep saying most of them.
But for me, obviously the body doesn't really matter. I only included the body just to show that most of the people have a physique as well. Like, it wasn't just
face,
you know, but this was just about the face, though. You know, I was just showing off their overall scores and other things. But so yeah, facial wise, that's my point. Brian Chain, he thinks he's like 3 points ahead of me, you know. And I was
I wouldn't say that.
Like, I was like, you know, I'm not saying I'm better or anything, but I don't think it's 3 points. Like, that's a bit extreme, but you know.
I mean, I can like show that girl the rest of them, because the only person I really had to rate from that video, the only other person was Wheaton, who she like, I think she rated him like, I forgot, it was like, yeah, two I think. Yeah, wow. And she rated you a 7. So
wow,
that's from an actual Stacy Light, I would say.
Yeah, crazy. And Brian, he said that if I look maxed to like the fullest potential, he said I could probably be a 6 at best.
that's cope, obviously.
I don't know.
I'm not sure about where you're from, but here, like in probably like America or California, like you would mog like most, like if you went to a club, you would mog most people facially. There's no like stretch of the imagination where you'd be a 5.
Because Chad Light is what, like top what, 10%, 20%?
Yeah, so like I don't see, there's no way, because if you're implying that you were a 5, that means that you'd be like right in the middle. So that means like that literally means like that, like everyone, like all the 8s would be like 6s or 7s by that scale. So wouldn't make any sense.
Wow. Okay. Well, I appreciate the feedback. I wasn't expecting that many compliments, but okay, I'll take it.
Yeah. By the way, I'm not like, I know it's just gonna like appear like I'm just like giving an inaccurate rating because I'm biased, but I'm like generally not biased, as you saw. Like, I don't have anything against these guys. You saw me give Wheat below average, and like, so I don't really have like any predispositions to hate on anybody inflate.
Like, yeah, I don't know you, like, so you don't need to pretend to hate me or anything, you know. So
I would say it would be interesting to look to see what you look like clean shaven, though.
Yeah, do I? I don't. Oh well, actually, we can pull up after. There's that picture of the debate I had with Alex, where that one. You know, Stefan, the thing I'm on about. I'm clean shaven in that, so you could probably.
the debate where he's like pulling up your Tinder pictures or something?
No, no. I'm just saying on the thumbnail of the debate, he has me versus him. I have a clean shaven beard.
And oh, okay.
So after, okay, let's just finish this and then we could just show him that. Yeah. Yeah.
This video, there's that's the end of the video basically.
Yeah, but I just wanted to see what I would, just to hear what I say at the end, like with the, you know, comparing the people. So.
Oh yeah, let's see.
Okay, so obviously, you know, you're a diehard fan of Buffalo. Like, would you agree that those guys are elite level? Or?
No, I don't.
You don't?
Yeah, I don't think anyone in that video is elite level. You're the closest to elite level, I would say. So that means you mock all of them.
No, no, I mean the guys at the end, like those guys.
Oh, I mean, obviously, Brad Pitt mogs like pretty much 98% of men. But even then, some people I've met, like for example, that same Stacey White I had rate like these, like you and Wheat, like she said she didn't find him attractive. So it is like, I mean, the female gaze is really weird, honestly. I would have to
hear a lot of women say that, because I heard Michelle say that too, but her taste is weird. She always says she likes lumberjack guys, and I'm like, that's such a minority of women.
Yeah. I mean, she said like she didn't find she only found him attractive in one video, like the one where he had like blonde, like long blonde hair. I forgot what movie that was, but she said that was the only movie she found him attractive. She did say
that you knew Josh.
I think it's Legend of the Fall.
I think so. There's one though where it was you know, if you look up Josh Holloway, she found him. She said he mocked Brad Pitt. Even though most people in the black pill would say not.
Okay, wait, but just before you pull that up, I just wanted to say between Roman Reigns and Brad Pitt.
Yeah.
Just to, you know.
Yeah, I've never heard a woman even mention Roman Reigns. I don't know. I mean, maybe she I don't watch
wrestling. There's videos. This literal video I took of him was literally just people, like, basically, as you say, simping for him, like, you know. You don't think he's elite level?
I would say he is.
Yeah.
Shot with his, like, hair, yeah, with his hair down like that.
Yeah, obviously he mogs the Brian and
Well,
that was the whole point of me showing them at the end, was saying like,
yeah,
this is what the elite level looks like. Yeah, I'm saying the bubbles look like these guys, so we can't be on the elite level. So that's my
point. I mean, it gets the point across clearly, but like, even without Brad Pitt, it gets the point across.
Yeah. Well, no, because like, look, nothing, but he.
I can't hear you.
My headphones are fucking
yeah.
What the fuck?
So far.
What? Oh, she's gone. But yes, no, I know. But let me ask you this. Nobody knew what was happening all along, right? You get the script and you read it and you write, right? So everybody must have guessed what this thing meant, where it was going. Is what is happening right now? I know you're not done. You're 11 in or something?
Yes.
And you have 18 total? Of,
yes.
Okay. So is it going in the direction that you had guessed?
No.
Really. It'll make sense. Everybody will understand. It's a great.
No, it will never make sense. Yes, it will make sense. I have faith that they're gonna bring it around, but
right now, done.
Right now, I'm still the same place I was in season one, and I quit asking questions. And I'm just like, okay, it'll make sense.
Yeah,
it'll make sense. Uh-huh. But now they've only got like six or seven left, and it still doesn't make sense. So
when's
it gonna make sense?
Yeah.
I don't know. So
no, not really. That
I, you know, anybody who's been watching the show, it is just there's so many different scenarios that it could be.
Yes,
it's. I can't wait.
I could see why women rank them highly. Obviously,
yeah.
Like the hair and all that. Like I get it.
Because they have a similar look, you know. But I just think Brad Pitt is definitely the better looking man. But.
Yeah, I agree too personally, but that's, I'm not sure. Like, maybe she is coping, but it's just, it was interesting to me because I was like, what? You think this guy mogs? Because, like, Brad Pitt is, like, seen in the black field to be, like, one of the most, like, in his prime, he was, like, one of the most, like, closest to, like, a genuine, like, 8 or 9.
Yeah, exactly. Facially, I think he's definitely up there. But yeah, this guy, like I said, he's a very similar image to him, but it's just not, I just couldn't see him being classified as the better looking guy if they were stood next to each other. He's not, he's still very good looking, of course. But,
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, well, that was interesting. Okay, Stefan, can you type in the Playing with Fire versus Gangster and just show them the thumbnail?
Oh, okay. Playing with Fire